Good morning to all of you. Today we will discuss about the insect antennae. Insect antennae are most often called feelers because the insect waves them around. This is a wrong name because they are not only used for touch. The antennae are actually the insect nose. They are used for the sense of smell. The paired antennae are made up of a number of individual joints. This means they can be very mobile. The basic form of antennae is filiform. In this type, there are many segments that are more or less equal in size. Filiform antennae are seen in a wide variety of groups such as the dragonflies, grasshoppers, crickets, book lice, biting lice, scorpion flies, and beetles. The length and number of segment joints varies much between them. Here is the antenna from which part it will be originated. As we discussed you to earlier about the head segmentation, here is the eye, here is the inverted Y-shaped suture. So in between the Y-shape or eye, there is the antennal socket from which antenna originates. The antenna are a pair of sense organs located near the front of the insect head capsule, although commonly called feelers. The antenna are much more than just tactile receptor. They are usually covered with olfactory receptors, can detect odor molecules in the air, sense of smell. Many insects also use their antennae as humidity sensor to detect change in the concentration of water vapors in the environment. Mosquitoes detect sound with their antennae, and many flies use their to gauge the air speed while they are in flight. Although antennae vary widely in shape and functions, all of them can be divided into three basic parts. The scape, the basal segment of the articulates with the head capsule. Pedicel, the second antennal segment. Flagellum, all the remaining segments individually called the flagellates. Here's the antenna, the part of the head capsule. Antennal socket is there, antennae is there, from which the scape is originated. The basal part is scape. The second was the small, that is pedicel. This is the flagellum, is the long part of the antennae. So this is the basic structure of the antennae. Structure of an insect antenna. Antennae are also called feelers. They are paired, highly mobile, and segmented. Antennae are located between or behind the compound eyes. All insects except Cnidaria have a pair of antennae. Antennae are well developed in adults and poorly developed in immature stages. Antennae is set in a socket of the cranium called the antennal socket. The base of the antenna is connected to the edge of the socket by an articulatory membrane. This permits free movement of the antennae. The basal segment is called scape. It is conspicuous, larger than succeeding segments. The second antennal segment is called pedicel, which is immediately follow the scape. A mass of sense cells called Johnson's organ is present in the pedicel, which is used as a chordotonal organ. Chordotonal organ in some of the insect like mosquitoes. Both scape and pedicel are provided with the intrinsic muscles. The remaining alveoli or the flagellomeres are known as the flagellum or cleola, which lack individual muscles. Surface of the flagellum is supplied with many sensory receptors that are innervated by the deuterocerebrum of the brain. The flagellum may vary in size and form. The function. Antennae is useful to detect chemicals, including food and pheromones, chemical secretions into air by opposite sex. It perceives smell, humidity change, variation in temperature, vibrations, wind velocity, and direction. Antennae is useful to perceive the forward environment and detect danger. It is useful for hearing in mosquitoes and communication in ants. Rarely, it is also useful to clasp the mate, clear, and grasp the prey. Antennae vary greatly among insects, but all follow the basic plan. Segment 1 and 2 are termed the scape and pericel, respectively. Thus, remaining antennal segments of the flagellum ears are known as the flagellum. Antennae function almost exclusively in its sensory perception. Some of the information that can be detected by insect antennae includes motion and orientation, odor, sound, humidity, and a variety of chemical cues. Some of the most common type of insect antennae with which you should be familiar or illustrated below. Here is the antennae basic structure. This is the type of antennae. This one is the cetaceous. This one is the filiform antennae, individual of the same size. This is the red antennae. This is the plumose antennae. This is pectinate antennae. This is lamellate antennae. This is monaliform antennae. This one is the capitate antennae. This one is the clavate antennae. Or this is geniculate antennae. Cetaceous, the bristle-like. Here is the cetaceous, filiform, monaliform, serrate, unipectinate, bipectinate, clavate, capitate, lamellate, aristate, stylates, plumose, pylos, or geniculate. So these are the type of antennae which are present in different groups, different insects. This is the modification of antennae. Cetaceal bristle-like antennae, size of segment decrease from base to apex, leaf of first flight, MC flight, the cetaceous. Filiform antennae, cockroaches and grasshoppers. This is the filiform antennae. Monaliform antennae, habitated in some termites. So, serrate antennae, shaw-like antennae, long of corn beetles. So, unipectinate comb-like structure in sawflies. Bipectinate is the double comb-like structure in silk moth. Clavate type antennae in bristle beetles. Capitate type in butterflies. Lamellate type of antennae is found in lamellae corn beetles. Aristate antennae in houseflies. Stylate antennae in horsefly and robustfly. Stylate. Plumose or the feathery in the male mosquito. Pylos in the female mosquito. Geniculate in bees and ant eagle. Ant weevils and honeybees. So this is a type of antennae. Thank you. Thank you very much.